Okay, guys, seed 5 match. Zealot Hockey Clan letter. So it's a bottom seed, but I don't know. TFTS has obviously some good guys with Rick and Chuzu and Backfish. Everybody knows them. And Erdinger is around for quite some time. And Squick, well, they are around for quite some time too, but recently decided to take it a bit more serious.
Yeah.
And Rick is in Twitch chat. Hi, Rick. Good luck to you.
Awesome to see that they are back in action. It's Quick voice.
Yeah. That's true. Okay, so we should be in game, yeah.
This is definitely not a bad game. There's definitely good people in it.
Sure, sure. And so you want to take it away at the start because I have to fix my tea. That's cool.
Okay, you go get some tea.
Yeah, thank you. Have fun.
Please don't tell me you're gonna put milk in that shit.
I am about to put milk in my tea. Yes.
God. Don't forget the puck cam. By the way.
I am.
So we got Erdinger with the puck, making some dupes, making some spins, gets wrecked by Mr. Duck Hunter. Oh, that was almost a great pass, but Erdinger intercepts pass to Suzuki, tries to snipe, but he does hit the post, and Duck Slayer now with the puck, passes it to Bukon, who passes back to Rig. Rig, good pass to Suzuki. Suzuki tries to pass to Erdinger, but intercepts. Looking hard, looking deep, hype. Duckling spinning around a little bit. It was a bad pass, but a good steal by Duckslayer, but some little bit awkward spins, not achieving too much with that. The spamming though. Spamming was good, shots not so much, unfortunately. Intercept Suzuki here again, Duck Hunter. Puck again, now Duckslayer is open, there he goes, he boosts in. Good defense by Erdinger though. Bukon passes to himself. He's gonna almost give a nice pass to Erdinger, but he wasn't quite expecting that. And just as he turned around, that puck went straight past him. Aldo Duck. Long pass, not very accurate. Aqua Duck can defend though. Back to Aldo Duck for another try. Good pass this time. Duckling.
And Chuzu.
We need to start seeing some better passes.
Chuzu was a snipe attempt. Goes wide.
For a while.
And Erdinger picks it up. Erdinger. Chuzu used already his boost. Duck Slayer. Wall passing it to Duckling. Also known as Duck Hunter, as we learned. Right?
Correct.
Yes, I got it. I'm really bad with names, so I'm a big fan of name changes.
We'll get it at some point.
And Rick Enzis out of his goal, good force field. Duckslayer bounced off it, so he bought a lot of time for himself. Now breakaway, Chuzu, Duckling in defense. Chuzu steals it though, and force field off Elder Duck is long enough. The tank goalie, who can boosts, and Duckslayer is in its way. Duckslayer going for a long pass to Duckling, good pass actually. He boosts right away. But only finds Erdinger. Erdinger. Last man with puck. Wall passes it to himself. Okay. Erdinger boosts. Finds Chuzu, who tries to go for a one-timer, but Duck Slayer in his shooting line. 1 minute to go in the first period. This will be a best of three. The Flying Ducks versus Ducks. Yeah, that's true. I don't actually know what Squick means, like if it's some short for something. Because I tried to search for the... for the clan tag, but they have some special letter in it, so it's tough to find for me.
Can't find it.
Yeah, secret clan.
No clue what it means.
Yeah, we'll find out. We'll get there. Bukan, 40 seconds to go. Chuzu, Aqueduct in position. Duckling covering the lane to Erdinger. Yeah, he does, and Aqueduct gets a pass too. So solid defense by the Ducklings, or the Squick guys.
Yeah, people need to get the passing needs to be fixed though, because the passing has been really, really sloppy. It's gonna be better. Maybe they're a little bit nervous. Could be.
Yeah, sure. More periods to come. Erdinger has a chance because the force field ran out, I think. And that will be the end of the first period. I think time will run out. Yeah. Okay.
Wait. Somebody is saying it means confused back of ducks on ice.
Oh.
That doesn't make sense. It doesn't spell Squick.
Yeah, maybe in a different language, right?
And I guess so.
So 19 to 13 passes for THDS.
Did you know though that the Duck Ling and Duck Slayer are brothers?
No, I didn't know that.
And when they play together, or I think they are brothers.
Okay.
And when they play together, they always go to each other's house, I think.
Oh, okay, I see. That's like cheating. I should probably blame them. Sitting in one room.
Yeah,
that because sounds fun.
I think Duck Slayer has a decent internet connection, and Duck Ling has a shitty internet connection. So he goes there to play matches, I think. This is all not confirmed, I think. I think he told me this one time.
Okay. Anyway, good to see.
Duck Hunter at the face-off with Erdinger. Erdinger wins the face-off. Good pass to Suzuki. That was good, but another like a bit of a pointless pass there by Suzuki. But they're still in possession though. Bukan is gonna pass to Erdinger. Good pass there. Spamming. Nope. Defense picks it up. Pass to Crescendo. Crescendo. Nope. Gets intercepted. Oh, and then Suzuki sniper. And the Pokemons.
Pokemons are out. Shizuka snipe. First goal for the Flying Ducks versus the Ducks. Let's call them the Ducks or the Quick Guys.
Who's your favorite Pokemon, Collins?
I'm really not a Pokemon guy, to be honest. But I know, I'm not the guy like saying, I don't know any Pokemon. I know some. Right? I would say I maybe watched like, I don't know, 5 to 10 episodes in total. I like the cat Meowth thing.
You didn't play the computer
game? Not at all. Didn't play any minute, not 1 minute. But I like the cat. The cat seemed pointless. Say again, please.
Did you not have a Game Boy?
I do have a Game Boy. It's still around, but it's like stuff like Tetris. That's Tetris and soccer game I played. But that's like, I think that's pretty much all I played on the Game Boy.
Pokemon, man. Pokemon was the shit.
Yeah,
I'm too old for this. Yellow Dog. That's like the hipster version of Pokemon.
And Elder Duck Holding. Maybe they changed something. Now we get to remember all the players. No, it's the same lineup. Still Poodle on the bench. Probably easier to remember. Shuzu winning the face-off. But Elder Duck with a good force field. Pass goes to Duckling. Who gets fancy, last man with puck, but makes up for it. Shizuka now clicks it forward. Shizuka with the red skin. Trying to find a pass, but misses Erdinger. Bukan has to catch as last man with puck. Bukan. Looking for a pass, probably. He has some time, it seems like. Shizuka boosting up. Duckling boosts behind him, but that steed was too far. And Aqueduct clicks it away. Aqueduct is Crescendo, right? I remember that.
Yes.
It's a strange engine. I think it makes sense. Aqueduct
you wanted to fit in, man.
Aqueduct is kind of funny. Okay, I see. But Crescendo was a cool name, too. Yeah. I like Crescendo.
But he had to adapt.
Yeah. Probably the price you pay to join the Squid Guys.
Yeah.
Aqueduct, last man with puck. Passing it forward to Duckling. Duckling. Boosts, tries to snipe on Rick, but only finds a post. I think there was a potential that went in. Tough to tell, so. Bukan, wall passing it to Shuzu. Shuzu versus Duckling. Wall passes it, goes through, and Duckling, good steal timing. Just clicks it to himself, so to say. Duckling, no angle for a pass, gets stopped by Bukan, and Bukan clicks it back behind his own goal. 1 minute and 15 seconds to go, while Bukan going for a fancy pass to Erdinger. Now Elder Duck blocking Shuzu and one of his own teammates. Aqueduct has to boost, catches it, passes it upwards. Bit of a sloppy minute there we had. Duck Slayer gets wrecked by Shuzu. Now kind of a breakaway, 2 versus 1 defender, but Shuzu didn't find a pass and got stolen by Duckling. Gets the pass back thanks to Bukan. Bukan doing a good job as defender, in my opinion. Good positioning and just passing the pass forward.
These ducks, though, they're like actual ducks. They swim together, you know. See, there's no, it's so chaotic on the field. But maybe it'll work out. But there's never like good passing opportunities when they have the puck, I think, because they have shitty positioning. this looks better though. This looks promising. Good pass. That player with the puck now. Ooh, Needs to make some kind of move though to open up some space for that pass. But good intercept though, good defense by Bukan blocking the pass from line. Suzuki now with the pass. Ooh, almost hit the one timer. I'm not sure if Edinger actually pressed the one timer there.
Good old problem with not seeing the one timers as observer, we only can guess.
Yeah, yeah. I think not, because I think the puck sticked.
Yeah, I think so too. I just watched the stream. Well, that's a tough one to tell. Let's take a look at the shot map. I always forget to look at it. Because the shot map, I actually don't like the points too much, but the shot map is kind of not bad, because you can maybe, if you watch the game closely, remember them some shots. Right? Maybe?
Yeah. Let's see.
No, only one shot for the ducklings by Duck Slayer.
Well, on the other end. Side also some.
Yeah, but I remember that was probably the snipe one.
Yeah.
And the goal by Shuzu, this snipe. I think it was in the bottom. I'll take a look at the points. Erdinger with the crown, 13 passes.
Yeah.
Rick with 100%, of course, and the fire, because he has four total saves.
Crescendo and Hunter are doing pretty good, like both 9 passes. That's pretty nice. But Duckslayer has 90 pickups, 3 passes. That's not good.
Nope.
47 puck time. It's not good. I think he needs to step up his game a little bit. I'm not sure if he's playing a lot lately, but. He needs to step it up. Duck Slayer with the puck. Pinning around a little bit, chilling. Gets stolen by Elder Duck. Oh, so wrecked. Good pass to Aqueduct. Nope. Bukan is defending pretty well.
Yes.
I mean, he also has 12 pickups, 12 passes. That is something that I love to see, you know. He didn't waste a single puck. And that's nice. Suzuki tries to dunk. Still. Half year after it was patched, Suzuki doesn't realize yet. Still trying. But, Duck Slayer. Shitty pass.
Wow. Yeah, you can call it like that, yeah, true. It's not the most quality game we had so far, but that's okay. That's why this.
Next game is gonna be better, I'm sure. They need to, like, feel each other out a little bit.
Yeah,
you know?
Probably. Get some of the nerves going. Or not going, so to say. Bukan with a good steal. Now Shuzu takes over. Not sure if Bukan's boost was on cooldown. Probably it was on cooldown. Shuzu going aggressive versus Duck Slayer. Giving it to Duckling. Duckling boosts in, but Bukan with another good positioning in defense.
Yeah, great defense.
Helping out Rick. Covering the side which is open. That's always helpful. Erdinger. Again, Erdinger. No pass to Shuzu. No, he tries. But Duckling gets it. Gets stripped by Shuzu, though. Should have passed earlier or tried to pass faster. Duck Slayer. Duckling should be in the bottom. There he is. And Duck Slayer gets wrecked by Shuzu. Now Shuzu messes up the ball pass. Aqueduct boosts through. Misses the pass to Duck Slayer, though. Shuzu steals it. Ball pass finds Erdinger and he shoots, but Elder Duck with a good force field. Now force field is on cooldown, but Elder Duck's positioning good enough for that shot. Duckling doesn't find Aqueduct. Bukan now going forward. Shuzu taking over death. 1 minute and 30 seconds to go. I think they probably gonna try to just go for breakaways to that team. The Flying Ducks it is, and Regensis with a crazy boost out for the fans. Looking for a pass now, going for a full power pass to Erdinger. Good passing skills by the goalie. Not too easy to make that pass, right? If you are a goalie and don't pass too much the whole game. Only 5 shots, so probably not many passes by Rick. So yeah, it takes some aiming.
True. Duckling. Around a little bit, passes to Slayer. No, Slayer with a little bit slow reaction, also bad pass there. But Erdinger wall passes to Suzuki. He's not gonna get a nice spin defense, very fancy by Crescendo here. Crescendo is gonna try to build some kind of attack here. 50 seconds left. What can he do? He should be walking a little bit more to the middle. Ah, not a great pass there, unfortunately. Bukan trying to buy a little bit of time. He's definitely not in a hurry here. Just walking around. Yeah, sloppy pass. Crescendo, oh my god.
Wow, sloppy pickup.
Must be nerves at play here, because this is very sloppy. But Crescendo, one last attack for the Ducks. Come on, good pass. No, unfortunately no good pass. Good steal, though. Oh. That's unfortunate. gonna go to Erdinger, and this pass is gonna be a wall pass. And this is gonna take so much time, the game is gonna be almost over. Suzuki. Suzuki spinning around, gonna go for the shot. Elder Duck though. 8 seconds, maybe, it's possible. Wall pass to Duckling. Good job here. Duckling passes to Aqueduct. Oof. Nice try, but unfortunately, like, if he spams closer to himself, he can control this puck. But
yeah.
It ended up being a bit of a sloppy shot. Let's see, goalie's doing a good job, but I think in the offensive side there was...
I mean, defense-wise, TFT is very good with Buchan, very solid, like not leaving his position and giving the puck all the time safe forward. Like he had 18 passes, only 4 received. That's like good for a defender, and so there's not much room for breakaways for the Ducklings. And then if you have like one guy who misses, I mean, we can really say so, he misses a bit out on his passing game with only 4 passes. I mean, even sure, Shuzu had that 6
though,
passes.
I mean, Suzuki also did not do a very good job with 36 pickups.
But it's a little bit because of playing position, right? Because if you're, both teams rotated quite a bit, I would say. Erdinger took over offense. So yeah, the guy with more offense time probably most of the time has less passes, right?
Exactly, but you can weigh that against the amount of goals and assists, right?
Mm.
So if I give my striker 36 passes, well, he scored 1 goal and they won, so I guess it was okay.
Yeah,
but if I give my striker 36 passes and he scores 1 goal and we lose, then I would say he did a bad job. Because he got 36 pucks. He scored 1. And he passed 3, so that means he wasted 30 pucks.
It's kind of true. So I guess the guys are lazy, and I'm open.
Like factual things, but you can kind of say, like, I think Erdinger played a good game, Buchan played a really good game. I would like to see Poodle instead of Duckslayer this game. I think it's going to be better.
Would be nice.
I don't really know how good Poodle exactly is, but Duckslayer wasn't doing it, so...
I played some pups with Poodle. I mean, it's always tough for me to judge players.
Yeah. Oh. We need some dogs.
New York Islanders joining.
Ducks. Oh, and we have Benny Bomb, but I forgot what his skill was. I'm also gonna give some.
Oh, another guy I need to add to the roster. Maybe it's a name change too. But I better have him in so people don't complain, right? Because it's technically not important because it's the first game. Oh, we have Düring for the Flying Ducks. Erdinger. And Duckslayer down. So Poodle isn't in the lobby. Let's kick him. It's probably not good that I have accepted some fast requests, I think. But I'm good with kicking. And I can add... I could add KIs, right, to make it snipe-proof. Toridas isn't on TSDF, yeah. That's a good thing that you can artificial player intelligence to just make the lobby snipe-proof. I hope this doesn't mess anything up. Benny Bomb will be benched. Duckling captain, probably, right? And who will be benched for the Flying Ducks?
Oh, sorry, I wasn't speaking. I was motivating in one particular player. I gave some words of motivation and advice. See? Maybe it helps.
So yeah, expected win, but it was a close win. So I would say props to the Squig defense and to Elder Duck, not allowing more than 1 goal versus Shuzu and Erdinger. I would say mission successful, right?
Yep. Yeah. Pretty. Yeah. Actually, it's like if you asked before the game, then you would expect the difference to be bigger, probably the result than 1 goal. But unfortunately, like. It looked less close than the score, you know, because they didn't really make chances. So that kind of shit.
Okay, interesting. So we have Shuzu on starting on the bench.
Where did Poodle go? Where's Poodle?
I don't know.
Oh, maybe you need to open the slot for Poodle. Or no, is he not coming?
ask. Let me ask. Rick doesn't want to have captain. Has to. I just want the KEs in, so I don't start with a guy that joined me. Okie dokie, poodle not coming.
Okay.
That's fine.
Well, I think we are like ready then.
I think so. Let's get one ready for Dice quick. I'm not ready, I didn't update the scoreboard. Wow! I will fix that immediately. Okay, Booker needs 1 minute. So I have 1 minute to fix it. Yay!
Okay.
So, here's a
In that case, I'm gonna get some water real quick.
Sure. Get hydrated. Pro countdown by me. Looks fine. And we are going. Going for the second game in this best of three. The Flying Ducks, the team in red, won the first match with 1 goal in the second period by Shuzuku. It was a snipe. And yeah, defense-wise, Quick played a good game. Good job by the goalie. Good job by the defense. But offense-wise, yeah, not too many scary shots on Rick, I would say. Nevertheless, Bukan did a great job for the Flying Ducks in the defense. Good positioning, as I said before. And now we have Shuzu on the bench. So the guy that scored for the Flying Ducks is on the bench in the second game.
Yeah, I'm not sure if it's going to be a super big deal. I mean, they were doing really good, like even though Suzuki wasn't playing.
Yeah.
He wasn't carrying them, at least for sure. So I think yeah, will be a nice match. It seems like they're going to play the same lineup though. No Benny Baum, no Poodle, but well, maybe Slayer can step it up.
And there he was, losing it to Erdinger though. Duckling picks it up behind the goal of Elder Duck. Duckling looking for a pass to Crescendo, also known as Aqueduct now. Aqueduct, click battle versus Bukan. Erdinger picks it up. I think Duckslayer should have picked that one up. Okay, Erdinger gets it in the end. And Elder Duck. That boost was a bit far. And Puck Cam, please. Thanks. I'm sorry.
Ooh, those were some pretty good spins though by Crescendo, but unfortunately he shot straight onto Rick. Nice try though. If he was a little bit cooler there, could have finished it off, because there was a really big gap on the other side of Rick. But nevertheless, looking good now, Aqueduct. Pass, unfortunately, good defense by Bukan for him. Bukan tries to pass Edinger, does not work out. Aqueduct, nice boost. Catches the puck, he's gonna go for a pass, no, pass, oh, nice try, but again, Bukan intercepts, he's blocking all these pass lines, Bukan doing a really good job. This time, Aqueduct intercepting, a lot of passes just being thrown in front of the middle of the goal, sometimes it works out, but most of the time you just lose possession. Ooh, nice shot here by Duckling, but a little bit too easy for Rig. Erdinger with the puck, he's going to try to pass to Bukan, but
Hitting standing players, not too easy.
No, it can be very hard. Sometimes it's harder than the skating players, man.
And sometimes it's really tough because you're so used to just aim right in front of the stick most of the times, because you're making passes when both guys moving forward. So, yeah, that's the go-to pass, so to say. So everything that differs from that, like passing a guy behind you going forward,
yeah,
or
sure.
Passing a guy going like opposite way of you, and passing a standing player, it's different, right? And not most players don't train this too much. And if you play like mostly pubs, and even I say if you even play privates, you get more of these situations. Nice wall pass attempt to Erdinger, but you get more of these situations where you pass a guy backwards or something, but
yeah.
I think you could set up a real good training for this game to get better.
Yeah, definitely.
The future.
And a lot of fast training, I think, is definitely something that people don't
Like people that want to get better, that they don't do enough. I probably spent like, I don't know how many hours, but insane amounts of hours just in lobbies with one other person.
Yeah, me not. I just recently checked the Ugly Pucklings news tab because Swedish Doll seems like not deleting any news, and there's like a news by me from 1 year ago where I said, yeah, I want to practice like not real games, just practice passes and stuff and do some strategies to say, yeah, okay, you stand now and stuff like this, but it never happened, and that's 1 year
really?
Ago. Yeah, yeah.
I did this like all the time with like, actually, Wukong is here, mm-hmm. We did it, and Crescendo, we did that a bunch.
I think if you get like really used to it and say like, okay, that's now like an attack where, you know, Wukong is standing still at this point, and everybody knows, okay, he will stand there, so yeah, there's a lot of potential in that, but I guess people enjoy playing too much, so... Like, hard work and hard training is not for everybody. And last shot of the period on Elder Duck's short corner. Saved, 5-3 shots. So yeah, some shots in the first period, but no goal.
Nope.
Free Benny is asked in the chat. Hashtag Free Benny. Yeah, maybe he will join.
Free Benny? It's like he's in jail. Hashtag Free Benny. Oh, he needs to be freed from the bench. Oh, I'm sorry. Wow,
that went
right over my head.
Oh.
I get it. Let's look at some stats, though.
Sure.
What do we got?
Stats after the first period. My favorite.
12 pickups, 2 passes this time for Erdinger. Let's see. Bukon was doing defensive work, I feel. A lot of defensive work.
Yeah.
Still. Like last game. I don't know. There's not much...
After the first period, I think it's
pretty... That's looking better, though. Yeah. Well, at least stat-wise. I mean, he's not wasting pucks. This time it's Crescendo, it seems.
Ah, 7 passes for a Duckslayer, that's not bad for one
yeah,
period, right?
That's good.
That's pretty, good to mention it.
What position the guys are playing, you know? Maybe they do like a rotation, but I don't really see any pattern, so it's hard to analyze the stats if you don't know what position the person is playing.
Anyway.
Erdinger. With the puck, walking inside, shoots onto Durant one time. Oh, actually, one of the drives here. Oh, and immediately makes a nice shot. Wait, is a ball in here also, or is it just Durant? It's just Durant, it seems.
Yeah.
They are actually pretty good, I think, both the drives. But they've been playing some draft. League, right?
Yeah.
For like at least past 2 seasons, I think.
Yeah, I know Durin was one time on my team, but didn't find too much time to play. I remember that. But I drafted him pretty early.
Yeah.
Surprising to the veterans. But I had some good public games with him, and now good to see him on the ice for TFTS.
Yeah, he's definitely not bad, I think. I haven't seen him recently, but in my experience, he's like... much better than your average pop guy.
Yeah.
So let's see. Hey, my puck cam is fucking up.
Yeah, puck cam is like you type out one time and then it wrecks for me. Wow, that stand by Rick. I don't know if that was safe, Rick. You should try to test that. Gap looked a little bit big. Erdinger now going offensive on Elder Duck. 6-6 shots now. Again, even game. Oh, I still have the music on. Wow, good thing that it's great music. I just realized that. Nobody
was
complaining.
It
yeah, it was like StarCraft Brute War soundtrack.
Some extra hype to this game.
Yeah, yeah. It's not a big deal.
Fuck. Aqueduct, Crescendo. Now with a good self pass. Oh, it's so open. Shoot! Come on. Why not just try the shot? Maybe Rick will panic or we don't know. Try it. Duckling now spinning around, gets stoned by Erdinger though. Unfortunately, he gets nothing out of that, and a great pass to Bukan. Bukan's gonna self-pass here, I'm sure. No? Spin around? No self-pass? Little bit of a lousy shot, but... Duckling, doing some spins, some self-passes. Nope, gets stripped by Bukan. Still doing a great job in defense. Now, gonna pass to Durin. No, sloppy pass. Maybe they can capitalize here. Crescendo, looking hard, looking deep. No, come on, make some kind of movement. You can't just keep walking and expect to get through, you know? You have to do something. Make a move.
Bust a move.
There was the move by Erdinger, boosting in. Duckslayer only finds Bukan. Back to Duckling. Bit of a messy period. Duckling with a very strange boost. You don't need his boost, it seems like. To make a pass to Duckslayer. Doin manages that. Duckslayer boosting in. Regensis, so cold, so cold. Say, speaking of Regensis panic, I think you know that Regensis actually played quite a lot goalie in NA, as I heard. So I think playing goalie in NA makes you more of a stone goalie. Because you realize the less you do, the better it is, kinda.
Yep. It's true, man.
Yeah, it's sad, but it's it is true, kinda.
Less is more.
Yeah, as goalie, it is really true. Because you keep more. Ooh, adding up. Nice job by Elder Duck. It's not too easy to make that steal, because it's some risk to walk out. Great. You can walk out too much, and yeah. For guys that don't know the game too well, you have to pay attention to like details in this game, and Elder Duck managed to steal that puck away, which isn't a normal move for a goalie. Not many goalie doing this, not your average public goalie will do this. Duck Slayer. Well, Elder Duck plays quite a lot of pubs, so maybe.
Yeah, for sure.
He likes training in pubs as goalie.
Well, 0-0 so far, and this time Duck Slayer with a crown, so yeah. I kind of gotta eat my words here. He's doing
good job. You motivated him
much better this time. So let's see what else do we got. We got Duckling. I think he tried some attempts. Let's look at the shot map. I'm pretty sure it's not Duckling. Yeah. Make a few attempts to score, but not working out. Duckling. Not
Duckling.
That many actually. See Crescendo with two shots in the first period there.
Yeah. But if you compare first and second period, you see like in the first period, like really close shots for the red team. And in the second period, the shots are less and quite a lot more away from the goal.
Yeah, that's true.
I think the shot map is kind of interesting.
Yeah, it's really interesting.
It's more interesting than the points for me. Maybe I'm a new fan of the shot map.
Yeah, I definitely like this shot map. Really fun to look at.
Okay, last period. The Flying Ducks leading in the series with one game. It's a best of three. So, if they win, we will have the Flying Ducks as the winner. And if they lose this game, we will have a third game. And Elder Duck with a good save there. Good job. The ball pass get caught by Duckslayer with a boost, finding Duckling. Duckling boosting in, tricks Durin, but doesn't get past Bukan. And now... Shuzu gets some distance to Duckslayer, but not enough. Wall pass. I know Duckslayer is good with wall passes too. Just have to be. It's a bit about confidence too, but have to be confident. Shuzu behind the goal of Elder Duck. That's scary, at least for me as a goalie. I don't like it, because you never know what the Pokemaster will be doing. Charging his shot probably, looking for an angle, but gets wrecked by Crescendo. Now Crescendo nicely clicks it forward, but misses the back pass we talked. Like, that's not the angle you do too often, and it's a lot harder.
About, I know Crescendo can pass so much better than this, but I am certain that he is nervous for this game, and he is definitely not playing to his potential, because I think he's actually like a good player. But Suzuki gonna drive the puck forward here. Lots of space for him. He's gonna go for the snipe, but Elder Duck saw that coming, and if he didn't, I'm pretty sure the defender was gonna catch it anyway. But Suzuki again, he gets the puck straight back from Elder Duck. Good pass to Durin, nice catch also by him. Gonna make a move? Nope. in the side net, maybe trying to confuse Elder Duck there. You never know. Yeah. Duckling though, with the puck. Nope, gets stripped by Suzuki. Snipe again by Suzuki. You say you never know what Suzuki's gonna do, but one thing you know though, it's gonna be a snipe.
Yeah, he likes the snipes. He likes the snipe, that's for sure, but he knows how to click the puck right in and abuse situations, and there he abused like the loose puck right in front of Elder Duck. And yeah, nice powerful shot with no charge time at all. So yeah, probably the mouse cursor inside Elder Duck's goalie, because if you don't know, guys, the further your mouse cursor is away from your player, the faster your shot will be. But most of you watching probably know that. Shuzu with a spin, and Elder Duck catches it. So 1 minute and 45 seconds to go for the blue team, for Squick to make something happen.
Yeah, I want to see one goal at least for Squick here.
Yeah, I hope so.
I mean, I think there's people are doing too much of the spamming. It's good sometimes, but yeah. People are doing it in a situation where it's absolutely useless. And they lose the puck because of it, or they lose... They should just focus on giving a proper pass, man. If you... I mean, if the level of the game is super high, but this level is not super high, you just need to give the pass to somebody else, and he needs to press C, and then you make it go.
Yeah, true, I agree. But that would intend that the more spam, the more the higher level. Yeah, man, I don't know.
I mean, there's self-spam. Yeah. I mean, I see in this game, people are spamming to themselves so they don't lose the puck, you know, for safety.
Yeah.
But then they give like a terrible pass and they just give the puck away anyway.
Yeah. You have to train. Oh, Schuso's free. Yeah, but Ducks there with good positioning. 45 seconds to go. Will we see a goal by the blue team? Come on, Squick, one goal. Ducks there. Oh, Rick is too cold to that night. Still not moving, Rick, not a bit, even though the gap without the force field was pretty what, Rick. That was like a bit too much pass. And Shuzuzu, a one-timer. Pokemaster strikes again.
That's the new one, the coffin for the ducks, though.
Yeah.
You got some drowning ducks here. Shitting ducks.
But it's okay.
Being tilted, yeah. It's a close game though, so it's still fun.
Yeah,
I think
not the best level, but it's a fun game.
Yeah.
And nope, you know, the loser will play. So most likely, Squick will play our new clan, New York Islanders. If I can manage to schedule that match. Oh, Pokemon strikes again.
With another snipe.
Ruin my prediction. So yeah. I tried to talk to the guys a bit, but yeah, you will see.
Suzuki 3 goals this time, yeah. I kind of felt like if it was necessary, Suzuki would have turned it up, and they were never gonna lose this game.
Yeah. So, Definitely Suzuki made a difference there in the end. Good job by Elder Duck.
Too strong for the Ducks here. But they need some practice, man. They need some.
Yeah, but I thought it could have been worse, to be honest. Like more of a pain for the Duck guys. It was quite solid.
Destroyed.
Yeah.
So, I mean, and they were nervous, I heard. So, I mean, a little bit of experience, a little bit of, maybe a little bit of strategy wouldn't be too bad.
Yeah.
And, I don't think it's, this was the first time in the Clan League again since a long time, right? So.
But the other thing is, I actually like, if you just have, like, really close the games and overtime, like, 90% of the time, or, like, 75% of the time games go to overtime, you could say that, okay, that it's not really a skill game, it's just random who wins, right? But if you see, like, clans getting beaten pretty hard and maybe getting a good chance versus a new clan like New York Islanders, and then you will see maybe the game will be a bit closer and we will have all three games.
Yeah, that's
then you can
awesome.
Say, yeah, okay, it is like, for me, I see it is a kind of a skill game, right? And it's also important that you see that skill is involved in this game and training, playing.
Yeah, I want to see this New Yorkers versus Ducks thing. It sounds like it's going to be really interesting.
Yeah.